You know what I mean? I took a lot of tranquilizers. I got a lousy sleep. I kept waking up. Like, I got a broken sleep. I woke up at 1 o'clock, 4 o'clock in the morning, 5 o'clock in the morning. You know?
Now, were you not able to sleep because of today's appearance?
Well, it's just waking up so early. You know, it's waking up early. That's no good. You know, I got to get 6 hours, and you know, for me to be okay.
Well, Marky and Joey are here.
Yeah, they're here.
All right, they're doing some sort of a. What are they doing? These two guys.
Right in front of you.
Oh, okay. Right in front of me. Marky and Joey, I invited them in. Joey wanted to come in himself. Joey Ramone of the Ramones wanted to come in himself. I said no, come in with Marky because him and Marky are always fighting. And he said, I don't want to come in here and fight with Marky.
I'll do anything for you with that.
I said, no, you guys got to come in together. Here comes, there's Marky.
Wow.
Hey, Marky.
How you doing?
Hey, man. Looking good?
How are you?
Thank you, Marky.
How you doing, guys?
Marky holding his copy of Crucified by the FCC. My own great work.
Your great tome.
Must be great to be one of the fabulous Ramones. I mean, seriously, what a great band.
It's a lot of perks.
Yeah, and a lot of chicks, a lot of action.
Well, I've been married for about 15 years already.
Is that right?
Yeah.
I didn't realize that.
Yeah, happily married.
Good. That's nice to hear.
Yeah, thanks.
Very happy for you. Where is Joey?
Perk is gone.
So it shows you can get along with somebody.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm
maybe it's not you, because Joey's not married to anybody, right?
No, Joey's married to no one.
I'm a get-along kind of guy.
And here comes Joey. Joey, watch yourself when you go. Go ahead. Hey, Joey.
I love Joey.
You can't even see Joey.
I just start to laugh.
Right.
How you doing?
Joey, I was just saying. Oh, they're shaking hands.
Have you seen each other this morning?
No, not yet. I just got up at about 6 o'clock. The limo was out.
I had a broken sleep.
I would have gotten here earlier, but I looked out the window. I couldn't see him. So, you know.
Joey, I know you have said, and Marky.
Should I let my hair down or leave it up?
Whatever you want to do. I think you look great with your hair up.
Oh, well, thank you.
I really do.
You'll be able to distinguish between you two.
Gary, every time a guest sits down, are we going to have that annoying noise of you adjusting the microphone? Obviously, this isn't working out, is
it?
I
don't hear it, Howard.
Am I the only one who notices the 10 minutes of Gary adjusting the microphone?
That's,
and, of course, I never can adjust it.
It's never at
it's right where it should be right now,
Gary's
Howard.
That's Gary's trademark noise.
Hold on. It's right where it should be right now.
He's in the studio.
But we have to sit through 10 minutes of noise.
No, but you say that's the first half. The second half is right where it should be.
Right.
I don't know noise.
Of noise.
So the answer is I'll have it checked out today.
Good, Gary. That away.
I don't know noise.
But somebody has to tell me.
No, when you're having problems, you got to tell people.
No, but somebody has to tell me. I don't hear it.
I know. I'm the only one who hears anything.
But how would I hear it?
I don't know. I guess I'm the only one who hears anything.
So thanks for telling me.
Gary's great.
You got dog ears. You hear everything.
Right.
I have them too.
Marky, Joey, I insisted that the two of you come in together because you are the two most interesting members of the Ramones.
Thank you.
Because you're always at each other's throats.
Would you say the others are bores or what?
Yes, I would. I had the other guys in here. They're boring.
I like someone who's honest.
Yeah, they were boring.
Yeah, they're great too. You know what I mean?
They're nice guys.
They're nice guys, but they're boring.
They'll do.
You know?
CJ's okay.
I find when I interview you guys, the two guys I really want to talk to are Marky and Joey.
You're dynamic. There's some tension in the room when you're there.
Tension. Tension is good, right? It's good for the art.
It's good for the blood.
It's good for
you
the
two
vitality.
Have been, you know, you're the classic two guys who are successful. I mean, the odds of making it. I must meet 20 guys a day who have bands who think they're going to make it, and they never do.
That's right.
The idea that you made it is a million to one shot. You have one of the greatest rock and roll bands in the history of this country. And yet, the sad truth is, the two of you no longer speak to one another.
Aww.
And I love this story, and I could revisit it 10 million times.
Now, did they speak prior to coming on here? Because you said they had agreed on something?
No. This is the first time we've spoken
How long has
maybe,
it been?
What, a year or
about
more?
A year,
year and a half?
It's so bitter that you two of you cannot. Even Ann Landers and her sister got together and broke the feud.
Well, maybe there's always a first time.
You know, me and my brother got together.
Yes. Why? Were you not with your brother?
I spoke to his brother yesterday.
You did?
Yeah.
What happened?
You know, my brother and him have the same birthday.
You know, we had the same birthday.
Why are you speaking to Joey's brother? That's what
I
wanted to know.
He called me.
Why?
He called me just to wish me happy birthday.
No.
Did he call you?
Yeah.
I don't know. You're just putting me on.
No, he called me. He called me, and he wished me happy birthday, and he wanted to hope that me and Joey would get along.
That was the reason for the call.
Ask a
question
here.
I mean, that was nice. At least there wasn't any bad vibes or you know, bad things going
Joey,
on.
Did you put him up to that?
No,
he didn't.
You know, I'm just starting to get along with my brother now, too, you know?
See, why? That's what I'm saying. Joey didn't get along with his brother.
Why not, Joey?
I think it had something to do with the birthday date.
Just because it was Marky's birthday?
No, why did you not get
along? No, it had nothing to do with that. It was, I don't know. It's just, it's the business. You know what I mean? It's the business.
Joey,
we're both musicians.
That maybe it's you who can't get along with people?
No. I thought about that. That's not me.
Right. Now, Marky, you said in the green room you do not want to fight with Joey.
Well,
you're afraid to fight with Joey.
I'm not afraid, but it's enough already. I think that we've exhausted all our fighting at this point.
And, I think we should have cockfights.
I think that if we're gonna fight, I think the words are enough already. But I think that the next step would just like say, hey, let's cut the crap, bury the hatchet, and
well,
move
what
on.
Broke? What was the problem anyway?
I never knew. I think Marky said some really weird things about Joey.
Well, we both did.
Well, you started, but
I mean, I'm forgiving. I mean, you know,
Marky, you wrote some weird things on the internet about Joey.
Well, we both did.
Well, I didn't have a computer then.
I didn't even know how to get on the computer. Here we go, you know.
Right. Well, I'm not fighting. Everything's cool. I want everything to work out.
Everything is not cool though. Marky said bad things about you, and you say that you had to respond. That's the story I always get.
Well, of course,
Marky, why did you originally start saying bad things? I mean, what precipitated it?
I tried to bottle it up.
I mean, usually people would just keep quiet. You did go. I mean, you would do admit that you said some weird things. Why? What pushed you to the edge? I have to finally find out the truth.
No, I didn't go to any edge. It's just that things, other people,
I can explain
on the internet. And then, you know, you try to keep off it, and then they would come back on again. And it's really people who try to instigate fights between
me. Why, you explain
it,
because that's not an explanation,
right.
Marky. No offense. Yes, go ahead, Joey.
I mean, I want things to be cool, but I'm going to explain why how this started.
All right.
It started at the very end of the Ramones when we got an offer to go to South America.
Right.
And it was for a lot of money.
For a lot of money.
Millions?
It was a lot of money.
It was a substantial amount.
All right.
And I told the band, I told John, I told everybody that after Lollapalooza, which was a 6-week tour or whatever it was.
Right, it was a tough tour.
Summer of 96.
It was a great tour.
Yeah, it was fun.
Right.
That I was finished. Then we did one more show.
You wanted to retire.
You didn't want a tour anymore.
I didn't want a tour. I didn't even care about the money. I just had it. I just had it.
You needed a break.
I needed to get away from everything.
What was it? Were you exhausted from the guys in the band, or were you exhausted from performing?
I was exhausted from the guys in the band.
Well, okay. You know, we were all exhausted.
From each other.
Because let me understand something. You were exhausted from the guys in the band because you're the lead singer. And it is very difficult because you have to use your voice every night. Is that what the problem was?
No, it's just...
We were getting on each other's nerves.
I don't understand. It's guys. Guys aren't like chicks, where chicks are like they want a relationship. Guys just walk away from each other.
In any business, after 20 years or whatever together, there's always going to be some kind of pressures going
on.
Well,
it's also like... When you're in a band, you got to make it work. You know what I mean? Everybody's got to make it work.
Right.
And
who wasn't
some people
pulling
in this
together?
Band didn't want things to work. Not
who
you, Mark.
Wasn't pulling together?
I always did my best.
So if Marky was
the
culprit...
I'm not talking about Mark.
Yeah.
I think you are, though. I think you're talking about Mark,
because why did you stop
talking to Mark?
He isn't. He isn't.
No, Mark... Everything was me and Mark. I remember we had dinner like... We were friends.
We were best of friends.
We were really good friends.
I mean, like, we'd go down in South America. We'd hang out. We'd
bang chicks.
Oh, sure. I can't say with Mark's wife listening. But,
he had his fun, and I was married. But we would go out and we would hang out. And
right.
We would have a lot of fun together. And then this thing in South America happened. And personally, I was disappointed.
Right, what happened in South America?
It was the icing on the cake after the tour.
You could have used the money.
I really didn't need it, but I would have liked it. You know what I'm saying?
Right. It's a nice cushion.
Yes, it was the icing on the cake, and it didn't
happen.
I was upset because I really didn't get any explanation. Now I understand.
Right. Did you think, though, that Joey could have, despite his exhaustion,
right.
couldn't Joey have just said, you know what, I'll do it for the guys?
Well, that's what I thought, but I guess...
Right. I didn't feel that way for the guys.
Right, but that's what I thought. I feel that now, but now I understand what he means.
But in a sense, Joey, if I was in the band, I'd say, you know what...
You know, Howard, if we were all friends,
right?
You know, like real friends,
buds,
it would be a different story. You know
right.
what I mean? Like some bands are buds, like
right.
the Chili Peppers.
So you
Peppers
really dislike everybody in the band?
No, there was certain animosity.
But you say the Chili Peppers were our buddies, and you felt if everyone had been on your team, you would have gone and done this. But I could see the band's point of view. The band
not
says
being on anyone's team. It's just being a person, being you know, just being.
What did they do, Joey?
Joey, please explain this.
I can't. It's too deep.
Oh,
well, you know, deep rooted.
There were animosities that started a long time ago, and I guess it got to a head to a point, and that's why we had to end.
It was things that started a long time ago and just got worse.
They
you
did.
Know what I mean?
They did.
You know,
because I would think if I was in a
who
band,
who wants to be hanging out with some fascist creep, right?
Mm.
Who was the fascist?
I think the guy who started the Ramones.
Not Needy.
No. You know,
no, the other guy, the guy,
Johnny.
The guitar, Johnny.
But I, not that I wanted to say that. I just, you know, we're being truthful.
You know, Howard, everybody...
He feels the same way about me, okay?
Everybody's a different personality. That was the problem, and we clashed a lot of times.
But here's the point.
We were the real clash.
If I was Marky or one of the guys in the band, I'd say, you know what? I devoted my life to this band. I, you know, I don't have anything to fall back on. Joey could at least one last time make us a pile of dough. And let us all go off into oblivion, happy with some security, with some money in the bank.
So
am I correct?
That's what I.
You know, take a bullet for all of us because we at least threw in
one
together.
One more time, but
I understand that. That's what I thought, but now I understand that you know the rigors of touring and all that stuff got to me too.
Right.
But why didn't Joey? He couldn't say that to Marky at the time.
Well, he probably did.
No, this all started after the Ramones. This started after the Ramones.
No, they took the tour in South America. You know what I mean?
How long was the South American tour supposed to be?
I said
it's going to be one show.
One show?
Yeah, just one show.
One show, Joey?
Was it one show?
Yeah, it was
I didn't even remember.
Howard, it was one show in 50,000 capacity stadium.
Right.
Well, you know, when you go down there, it's a real pain in the ass when you go down. I mean,
you can't go outside. The fans attack you, which is great. Because to have anybody
attack you is beautiful.
To have that.
I love being attacked.
Right.
That sincere of being your fan is great. Because
right.
a lot of bands wish that.
I mean, I love the fans down there. You know, the Latin people are great. They're so passionate.
They are. They're passionate about their music. They're Ramones.
But Joey just quit. He didn't even give an explanation.
No, I did. I said I'm done after Lollapalooza. I did the Power Show. That was the last show, and I was
you
done.
You wanted time to yourself.
I wanted time to savor all the glorious days of the Ramones.
We all wanted time for ourselves. But
right.
Looking
I wanted
back,
to do one show and then make a bunch of dough.
Well, that's what I thought.
Yeah, then you have plenty of time.
You know,
you're very practical that way.
They were talking about a long South American tour.
Like the whole
one show you told.
The thing is that, you know, we're all individuals. People wanted to go their own way, and you can't force anyone.
Joey, are you so rich you could turn down that kind of cash?
I'm comfortable. I'm content with myself. You know, money isn't everything.
Wow.
So then when did the animosity start?
Well, there was a bad vibe after the band broke up.
There was a bad vibe throughout the band.
You can't really pinpoint it when it started, but it was a long time.
It started in the early 80s.
He can
Joey
pinpoint
has
it.
It
started in the 70s.
You know it's from the beginning.
But Howard, we managed to stay together for 20
You guys 20 seem
years.
Like so much fun. I can't imagine that you couldn't have fun.
It's like you put your differences aside, and, you know, you're doing it for the love of the band, for the music, for the fans.
Yeah. So now you understand why the Beatles broke up, right?
The Ramones are like an animal of their own.
Well,
you know what I mean?
Yeah, the Beatles were only together for, I think, 7 or 8 years before they broke up. We were together for 20 years.
Right.
So,
you had a longer run.
Yeah, we did. And
we didn't make as much money, but we had a longer run.
Right. Yeah. Understood. Yes, go ahead, Baba Booha.
You know, Howard, like, I'm a really, really big Ramones fan. I have been for ages. And when I hear this stuff, it sort of cracks me up. Like, the last time they were on here, they said that they would get in a van and drive somewhere for 6 hours. And four guys wouldn't talk to each other.
I know.
Well, that was
that,
it.
That's why it's strange.
We should never have been traveling together.
We thought.
Why add to
to the, you know, to the Fury.
Do you think you could have gone on with the Ramones if the guys all traveled separately and you just showed up, did the gig, and then left?
I think that if we played select places and cooled it with the touring a little and took time off here and there.
Yeah, if we had more time to ourselves, because there was never any time.
It was a heavy barrage.
And if we didn't travel together.
And continuous, about 120 shows a year. And I felt that if we cooled it and played half that amount, we'd be able to do it.
Right. I mean,
you know, when I traveled, sorry, Robin, I'm sorry to interrupt you, but
he's got some things to say.
You can talk every day on the show. And
right. Go ahead, Joey. Go ahead.
Well,
aren't you glad we got you together?
I'm happy.
Very happy.
I'm
very happy. It's good to see you and everybody.
I'd be a lot happier if you were yelling at each other.
It's good to see you.
That was the last time.
Right. Howard, do you want to see the band maybe get back together at some point, right?
Right, right. Yes, I would.
And if we're yelling at each other,
it's never going to happen.
And we get knives and guns.
Let's take some phone calls.
Are you talking to the other guys now? Joey.
What?
Are you talking to the other guys now?
No.
I talked to CJ. We're friends. Matter of fact, I'm throwing a big show on this Thursday, the 22nd, at Don Hill's, and CJ's playing.
Yeah, I got to plug something too later, though.
All right, let me plug
it. Mark's playing at the Continental.
Let me plug your in-store before we take a couple of phone calls for the Ramones. Ramones in-store. Okay,
now, the Ramones will be there.
This is the first time.
I think so.
Yeah, this is the first time Joey, Johnny, Dee Dee, Marky, and Tommy Ramone. We'll be
together.
You
know, it was all Tommy's fault.
We were there at the
video. No Shemp.
Howard, we were at the video
Curly.
Signing the last time.
Yes.
This is the second time we're all going to be together.
Oh, okay.
All right. You will all be together. Will you talk to one another? Be honest.
I will. I mean,
will anyone talk back to you, though?
That's their problem.
Right. You will begin talking to other people.
You're about peace and love.
Obviously, I'm friendly with Dee Dee and Johnny. Tommy, I don't see often.
Right.
Now that Joey's here and we're getting along here, I can't see why not.
Okay. And Joey, will you talk to the other guys?
I'll say hello. I like Tommy.
Right.
I like, I used to like Dee Dee at one time.
Right. Right.
John, I'll say hello to. He'll probably just give me some weird nod or something.
Now, Joey, what about these rumors going around that you're not healthy, that these are your last days? Would you dispel this?
These are my last days on Earth, like JFK.
Is there any truth to this, Marky? Have you heard these rumors as well?
I'm not saying anything.
You're not going to say anything?
I'm not saying anything.
I just don't believe in flying small planes.
I'm not saying
that.
That was bad.
That was a bad scene.
No. I feel real bad.
I think he could have been the next president.
That sucked, man.
You think he could have been the next president?
He wasn't even running.
Yes, I do.
He would have won, even though he wasn't running?
I think 10 years from now, he would have gotten enough experience in life and society and all that stuff in politics that he would have been able to run.
He was a cool guy. He wasn't
The Democratic Party needed somebody like him.
Someone with charisma.
That's what he had.
Right.
And I feel that all the nostalgic and all the other things that happened with his father.
Now, Marky, have you ever read a newspaper, or are you just saying this stuff off the top of your
head?
Of course.
Joey, yeah, you too? One.
Oh, no, I read.
I read the New York Times every day.
Do you really?
I'm literate.
No. No,
Joey, what about your health? Is everything okay with you? I'm really concerned.
How do I look?
You look great.
Thank you.
All these rumors going around that you're dying of cancer?
That's because he quit, I think.
I quit cancer. I kicked
Did you ever have cancer?
No.
You did not?
No,
I once had the common cold, though. You know?
You did. So, Marky, why are these rumors going around about Joey?
Did Marky start these rumors?
I believe Marky started it.
I got an ache in my shoulder.
I'm not a doctor. I don't know how these things started. And here he is. He's here to tell you whatever he wants.
I'm here to tell you I'm living.
You look great.
Yeah.
You know, Dee Dee said I was dying of cancer.
I think so.
Why did Dee Dee
say it? Mark said that, too.
Marky said it, too.
Oh.
Marky, you did say he was dying of cancer.
Listen, Howard.
Go ahead.
I read something, and when we were fighting...
Was this on the internet?
No, it wasn't on the internet.
Right.
I read something that somebody said in a magazine. Howard, I was the last one to know.
Right.
Okay?
Oh.
I was the last one to know.
All right.
And
aren't you always the last one to know?
And he's here.
Right.
Let him say what he has to say, and that's where it's coming from.
Because he looks great.
Okay, he looks great, and he sounds great, and that's it.
I want to just leave a good-looking corpse.
Yeah. But Joey, you are fine. You have no cancer.
No, I'm feeling pretty good today.
You're feeling pretty good.
Yes.
Yeah.
Give me a hand.
So, Marky, that was just a vicious rumor started by one of the other Ramones, is what you're saying?
I'm not going to implicate anybody. I want to keep a friendly thing going on here.
And, Joey, what do you think this rumor started?
I see these people today at the in-store. There's going to be thousands of people there.
Right.
And I want a good vibe.
Now, it says here you will only sign one item, Only if they buy something. Is
what,
that true?
Like baseball players?
Well, Howard.
Yeah, you're like
Howard.
Joe DiMaggio.
It's
yeah.
an anthology and something to be very proud of. And I think the fans,
it's the
fans are going to like it. And I think that they will want to buy it.
Joey, were you in on the creativity of this Ramones anthology?
Yeah.
Yeah, we all were.
You all were in it together.
Start to finish. Yeah,
yeah, we all right.
But you weren't there at the same time.
No, actually, none of us.
No.
Well, John was there. He went to Ron.
You all worked on this album separately.
Yeah, John lives in Los Angeles.
It must have taken years to get this together.
No.
How does that work?
Not 6 months. It was
well, yeah,
together.
The idea was only about half a year ago.
Gary Stewart was his idea.
Yeah, at Rhino.
I see. And then you separately?
It's a labor of love.
They called us separately, and I went to their offices. John went to the offices. Joey was.
Where will you be appearing today?
No, I'm here.
At Virgin Megastore.
Union Square.
Union Square.
14th and Broadway.
7 o'clock.
7 o'clock tonight.
Right.
And it says here, please note the Ramones will sign, hey ho, let's go, and one additional item with purchase only.
That means you can get your shoe signed or the record signed.
How it is
right.
going to be so many people that you have to give time for everybody.
All right, let's take a phone call for the great Ramones. This is a very rare appearance to see Joey and Marky in the same room. Usually, this would never happen. This hasn't happened in, what, a year?
A year and a half.
A year and a half.
Only
friendly
you
attitude.
Could make it happen.
Right. And I believe
only
it.
Only you. You got that power.
And I say stay tuned because I
Hallelujah.
Believe they will start fighting. Something will happen. Yes, Evan, go ahead. You're on the air with the Ramones.
Hey, Howard. Yeah. Didn't Marky say on the show one time that Joey was like a Siamese twin or something?
Yeah, let's clear all this up.
Said that.
You did say Joey was a Siamese
never
twin.
Said that on the show.
Really? Where did you say
it? Did I say that?
I swear I heard it.
Did you call him up at his house and say that?
Wait. You had that on tape? I never said that.
I don't know. I'm asking you
never
a question.
Said
you never
I
said
never
that.
Said that he
Joey, were you born a Siamese twin? Let's clear that up.
Do I look like a Siamese
twin? I mean, that sounds,
yes.
that sounds crazy.
Maybe I read on the internet.
That sounds crazy.
I believe you and I are Siamese
I
twins.
Think you, right. We were attached from
no,
the
no,
detached,
I mean, you know, that's totally absurd.
All right. Let's see. Okay. Chris, you're on the air.
I didn't say that.
Totally
yeah.
absurd. Yes. The
hey,
Ramones
Howard.
Are. Yes.
I heard Marky said girls are repulsed by Joey.
Did you ever say girls are repulsed by Joey? Because I know girls, beautiful women, that want Joey.
Well, the last time we had our fighting, I think I might have said that, but Joey said things about me, too, and
right.
that was the past.
I've never had a problem with girls.
And I've seen some of the girls Joey's been has gone out with, and they're knockouts.
They are.
Yep.
They are.
So you were just saying things.
Yeah, we were being...
You were just being cruel and vicious.
Yeah. I mean, we're both good at that.
So you want to retract that now? Women are not repulsed by Joey?
The ones that I saw, they were real, real nice.
Right. Some women are repulsed by Joey. Is that what you're going to go on record saying? But the ones you saw him with were not.
No, but what I'm saying is that we fought in the past, and these were just weapons we'll be using
right.
against each other,
right.
and that's
see,
over with.
Good, all right,
like,
I see.
Like Star Wars.
Right, okay.
Lightsaber.
And that's it. No, some of the girls were really amazing.
Right, Julie, go ahead, you're on the air. Julie.
Hi, Howard.
Yes, hi.
I remember hearing that Joey said Marky was two-faced.
Joey said Marky was two-faced.
Yeah, what's that about?
Boy, everybody remembers everything.
Wait, Howard.
What memories?
Wait, yeah. I have two faces. I'm two-faced.
Are you? Is he two-faced?
Yes.
Oh, here we go. Right?
I'm kidding.
Yeah, he's kidding. Okay.
Todd, you're on the air.
Howard, how you doing, man?
What's up?
You know, didn't Joey say last time that, like, it's really not worth the aggravation to come on the air with Marky? He's just a hassle all the time.
I thought about it. Remember, I turned Gary down, but then I thought about it when I was, you know, in the morning, you know, after a good cup of coffee.
See, Howard, there's always instigators who want us to fight.
People want you to. I know I want you to fight.
It's like, you know, they can't say, well, why don't you guys get along and get on with your lives?
Will you two leave here today talking to one another? You will not. You will not go into the group.
I will. I'm going to call.
I think so.
I'm going to call Mark up.
I think so.
Really?
You know why, Howard? I feel the good vibe in the air.
Really?
And
the force is with us.
And the force is with us.
And Joey, you are feeling the vibe as well?
See, Howard, this is different because the last time was so bad. This is so good. It's like.
So maybe this is good. All right. Zachary, you're on the air.
Yeah, I remember Marky saying that people were laughing at Joey at Lollapalooza because he gained so much weight and he looked like a fat slob.
Marky, you did say that. What about that? You made fun of Joey's weight. Isn't that true?
Well, that's when we were fighting.
That's
and
right.
You know what, Howard?
Yes.
I gained a few pounds, too.
You did.
Well, you know, Howard, I lost about 30 pounds.
Yes, I see. You're very trim and fit.
You could say that Joey slimmed down.
Do you know why I gained that weight?
Why?
Because I was miserable.
Right.
Because being with the Ramones, I was miserable.
I gained the weight, too, because I was miserable also.
And are you working out on a treadmill? Is that what's going on? Are you on a diet of some kind?
We went on a diet.
We went out and got the treadmill together.
What kind of diet are you on, Joey?
Well, I love sushi. I'm on a sushi diet.
Right.
No Ramones diet.
I'm on the treadmill. The treadmill diet.
You are on the treadmill.
Yeah.
I would have to see that.
Marky, didn't you say Joey had hair extensions also?
I might have, but I don't remember. Probably.
Joey, do you have hair extensions?
No, I don't.
You do not.
No.
Well, there
it
is.
That would look corny, right? Hair extensions?
That's
out. Yeah. That's not happening. All right. Well, there it is.
So, Howard. Are you going to come down tonight?
Yeah, I'm going to try and get over there tonight.
Why don't you come down?
All right, I will try, but who knows?
Why don't you introduce us?
Really? What, at a store? A record signing? It's not like you're going to perform.
No, here they are. They're
going to do a circus. Bring the dog along. Dog ass.
You know? Go see the Ramones in store. Because chances are a fist fight will break out.
Can I plug something, please?
Please, go ahead.
All right.
You have some new band. I saw a picture of you in the paper.
Thank you. I have my own album coming out today on Universal, and it's called The Answer to Your Problems with a Question Mark, and we'll be playing at Wetlands July 26th, Monday at 9 o'clock.
What is the name of your new band?
The Intruders.
The Intruders.
And I have that video I gave you that's on Rhino of the Ramones Around the World that I put out and produced with my own footage.
Yes.
I think it's there somewhere.
Joey, do you object to that? I see you laughing, because why would Marky get to put out his own video of the Ramones and you not involved? In it.
No, I get the money.
He's in it.
You do. He's in it, but he didn't have any say over it.
Well, you know, I went around the world taking a camera. I'm the one who did the work.
I'm not even on the cover.
You know what I mean?
Well, you know what I mean. Maybe Joey didn't like some of the images.
I have no idea.
Did you watch it, Joey?
I watched it before I proved it. It's great.
Yeah, it is great. Okay, so you did have approval.
The artwork.
But I'm not on the cover.
The artwork was left up to other people.
Why is Joey not on the cover?
Ask Rhino.
Marky, are you on the cover?
Not really. No,
Mark's
what?
On the cover.
Wait, you know what it is?
Mark, why would you be on the
Mark
cover?
And John
Howard,
are on the cover.
People at Rhino probably thought that I was Joey with the fans.
I don't think so.
You know what I mean?
Right.
So that, because sometimes they confuse us.
Joey, did it hurt you when you were not on the cover?
I laughed. I thought it was funny.
Right.
So, Howard.
Now, does Marky get along with the guys in the new band?
Yeah.
Hopefully not.
The new band's great. But,
if you don't, come in here with them.
I just want to say something about Joey.
Go ahead.
Doing a benefit at Don Hills for a band who got their van robbed, and that's great because they need money to get a new van.
Van, all their equipment,
and it's great
personal belongings.
It's great that he wants to do that, because I don't know too many people.
Well, I manage this band. They're called the Independents. They're
and they
great,
got
great
the van
band.
Robbed completely with all the equipment.
All right, so that's nice.
And a lot of cool people are playing. The Pristines, Ronnie Spector, Los Gusanos, which is CJ's band. And about 13 bands are playing.
Right.
I'm playing.
There's certainly a lot of plugs with you guys.
Can I say hello to Jesse from previously D-Generation, now PCP Highway?
I prefer you didn't. Thank you. Joey, Marky Ramone. All right. We'll be back right after these words.
I got to go take a dump.
Hey, I heard you left it up.
I got to take a dump.
Hey, Marky, you feel like you guys have made up now and you guys are all set?
Yeah, it's good. Thanks.
You feel it?
Yeah, I feel it.
You